myself, my name is Antonio Benitez, so I'm from Mexico. The transition that probably many of us have in regards to having a full-time job and then going to what it is your project and how would you like to set it up. This plantation that originally started as information. I was going back to Mexico every year, and then all of my friends and family, they were asking, so how is it to be living there in Asia? How is it to be living in Hanoi? I was living there for a year as well. So every time something that I see to myself like a normal, every time I go back there, everyone was like willing to listen. What was the difference between there and here? So then I was thinking, so there's probably there a niche to fulfill. And originally there was this information in tourism. So we have France, Spain, the US and China. That's how normally it goes in regards of tourism arrivals. But then when it comes to expenditure, those countries, they kind of switch a little bit interesting. So actually people visiting those countries, then we have in number one, the US with around 200 million. So it's $200 billion that they receive up to, according to the World Tourism Organization, 2016. So it's around 200 billion that they receive. Then after that, we have China with 115 billion, something like that. And then we have Spain and France. So France is actually getting a lot of people there visiting, but probably not spending too much money when they come there to France, right? But then it gets interesting when we have these same countries when it comes to the level of expenditure, actually. So those countries where they travel outside their own sphere. So we have China as a number one, of course. So now China is getting closer to almost 300 billion. So that's $300,000 million. And then the second place, we have the US with like around 120 billion. So it's almost like one third of the money that the Chinese market is spending outside in all these different countries. So Chinese market is going to different countries here in Asia, mainly US and UK, but now it sounds very interesting for Latin America and countries like Mexico. So that's why they wanted to know how can they entice the guests and make it to come here and try to spend more money. The moment that you engage both sides of the coin, not only as a user but producer, then you're going to have this growth going really exponentially. And that's kind of the idea of the companies, but something that is more looking more normal is a little bit like this, right? We have the first stage here. This is something similar to like a honeymoon. You know, when you get married, you have, it's called like this, an informed optimism. So probably at the beginning you're thinking, everything is gonna be fine, so everything, you're in love, like totally fine, and you have already seen the idea of your spontaneity or your service or your product, you think it's gonna be all good. But then, as you progress in time, then you realize that probably that partner that you have, you know, they're having the new habits and maybe you're not crazy about those. And then, but it's something that you cannot avoid because it's just on the learning process and it's just gonna come with time. So you do a little bit more research and then that's what is called the informed pessimism. You know, here you start to find the first problems in your organization and then you do a little bit more research. That's why you think like, well, it's gonna be a little bit harder than what I thought. And then you continue there. It depends on how strong you have achieved your values and if that's what you really wanted to start as a joint venture. Then we have something called the crisis. Crisis meaning, so here it's kind of a turning point. Fixed mindset is gonna be that people who hold back and they're not gonna be willing to jump or challenge themselves because they wanna make sure that whatever they do, it has to be good. Otherwise they wouldn't do it. So, I mean, of course, in one sense, that's very good and well thought, right? But then if we have this fixed mindset, what she's suggesting is we need to change it into the growth mindset. And for example, this fixed mindset says, failure is the limit of my abilities. I hear it says, well, maybe you can learn that as well. Or I stick to what I know. I hear, I like to try new things. So the idea is that every time we're going into this bumpy ride to see where are we standing and try to see, is this an act of a fixed mindset? And if you realize that it is, well, probably you can then change it to the growth mindset. I mean, there's going to be many opportunities there to change. Maybe that person, as opposed to the other one, is going to be very good with, I don't know, like setting up strategies and actually looking for the right keyword to put it in your website, or you know, actually, as I was reading as well, Baidu, I think it accounts for 75% of all the searches in online. So that's a lot. So it's also one of the things that we need to, if we go into the platforms, we need to make sure that everything is kind of tailored. You know, try to find a specific keywords, and you know, because we're dealing with different markets, as we just said earlier. So we just need to realize exactly how to work on that. And this is the last thing that I have. Is normally some of you are familiarized with this. Is what it's called the PLC. It's the product life cycle, right? So what is also called sometimes the S skill life cycle. So one of the things is that we always need to reinvent a little bit ourselves because we need to embrace the new things and new opportunities. We cannot just get stuck in what we know, because we've seen what has happened before, right? Even with the best companies before in the world, like when they were here, for example, what happened with the, I don't know, with Nokia, right? I mean, what was wrong with them? There was really nothing wrong, but they just didn't innovate. So they didn't embrace the change, right? So not Nokia. So we also have Kodak, for example. Do you remember Kodak? No, with the photos, you know? So 10 years before, they were just breaking records on sales, and then 10 years later, bankrupt. So it's just about really to realize that we're not gonna be always here, and we need to innovate. As much as you think already like everything is going good, but we just have to always you know, embrace. And same things happen with many other ones. Huh? Motorola, I don't know, Blockbuster, now the new Netflix. So all these companies that really, we believe there was nothing wrong with them, but they just didn't embrace the change. And so we need to realize here, so we hopefully do the next extension here.
You know, people want to know acquaintances, their businesses take a nosedive because of the lack of the growth inside.
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, sometimes the skills that we're looking now is more than the technical skills, which are very good. We wouldn't do anything without the technical skills, right? Because I don't want to be taking the plane with the pilot that doesn't know. So you need to know what you're doing. But then also nowadays, the growth mindset is really like interesting. And you know, that's what I say, like more than the idea. So it has to come down to the action.
Right now, through this digital, it is really incredible. I don't see before